Stop allowing wounded men to take advantage of you. So I keep running into this scenario with women in our community where they come up and they're like, oh, well, there's this guy and he's really great and he's so amazing and he's awesome, but he had this thing that happened in his past and this woman really hurt him, and so he's kind of scared of a relationship, and so I don't want to freak him out, so I'm not pressuring him to get into a relationship, but we're having sex and we're, you know, doing all these other things, and I'm just going to hang out and wait until he gets better, or I'm going to try to fix him, or I'm going to, you know, help him out and work with him and try to figure out what's going on with him. And this almost never works out, because what ends up happening is when you try to do this with a guy who's really wounded, what happens is that one of the big motivations that men have for kind of healing themselves and figuring themselves out and getting a lot of their emotional and mental things worked out and figured out is that they want to get into a relationship. They want to be connected with a woman. They want to feel loved. They want to have that nurturing feminine energy around them. And so they'll end up healing themselves and figuring themselves out and getting their stuff together for a woman or for the possibility of getting into a relationship with a woman. So if you're giving a man all of those things without him needing to fix himself beforehand, what ends up happening a lot of times is that a guy will end up never fixing those things because he doesn't have that goal anymore. He doesn't have that need to do it because he's already getting his needs taken care of. So if you're falling in love with a man's potential, but he's not giving you what you want right now, you're in for a really rough time and you need to stop doing that.